welcome back to this edition of Wealth Builders. I'm here in the studio with our special guest, Charlie Kohler, with Fight from San Diego Fight Club, and Lauren Mueller. So, Lauren, we were talking about fighting styles. Before we went to this last break, you know, I remember back in the day as a kid, I used to, you know, play with the Mike Tyson Fight Out, then Fight Night, and I always loved certain fighters that fought Southpaw, you know. What's your fighting style? What's your strength as well?
My fighting style, really, I'm learning everything, okay, kind of at the same pace, so I can be really well-rounded in this sport. And I have a lot of people I have to catch up to, so I don't want to just stick to what I like the most.
Correct.
But I would say my strengths is probably my striking and jiu-jitsu on the ground.
Okay.
My ground game is pretty strong.
So you're ground and pound.
Yes.
Huh? She's strong on the ground.
Yeah. I didn't get to see that in the last fight. There wasn't much time on the ground.
Right.
So
yeah.
I was wondering about that.
Yeah, I think her strengths are, I mean, she hasn't shown like some of her strengths, and there's so many facets of fighting, so many in between and transitional positions that we go over as a team and a unit that she's good at. She's really good at, and she isn't exposed, but she didn't need to.
Yeah. I saw that look in her. She was like, my ground game on.
Yeah, her ground game's so funny. She wrestles the guys, and people think, man, this girl is strong. She knows how to deliver pressure and then move fluidly, which is a very hard combination to do. So she's athletic and she's methodical, which is very important to be patient and understand where you're at in all facets. So,
is that where you're comfortable at most? Is ground game, or are you just kind of one of those, I can do it anywhere, anyhow, it doesn't matter?
I feel like I can pretty much do anything. If this person's stronger at striking, then I'm going to take it to the ground. If for some reason they outdo it somewhere else, like I can pull from different things, so I'm pretty confident with that.
That's great.
That's as a coach, that's what I want to develop. It's like, okay, we have options. You know, we're not just one way or another, and you're always going to have something you like a little bit more. It's just training is a little bit easier maybe that way, but at the same time, we need options. We need game plans, and four or five different game plans coming into it, and some alternative game plans. If you don't have an athlete that's able to do those, it's like a quarterback. He's got to make all throws.
Yes.
If not, man, he's going to just figure you out.
Yes.
And now you're in trouble.
So let me ask you this. Going into fights before we close out, I mean, do you have any motivational music, any routine rituals that you do, or traditions? Like, you know, most fighters, there are certain things that they have to do before they fight, or even athletes.
You know, I just try to, every day, I try to keep things kind of the same.
Mm-hmm.
As far as the fight day, to keep my nerves under control, I just go ultra calm. Like you saw from my last fight, you came to the gym.
That?
And it's almost like, it's hard to explain. I just kind of tune everything out. And
you
stop talking
to people.
I don't talk to people, pretty much the whole day. I just stay real calm. Put my headphones in.
And we try to create the atmosphere. Every gets their buttons pushed a little bit different, but in general, just like most sports, you want to get relaxed. And we put people and teammates in situations around her and other fighters to relax them. And sometimes we'll sit there and joke. We'll kneel each other, laugh about, dude, look at your hair, or check that out. You're going to, you know, just really keep it as relaxed as possible and keep it moving so you're not sitting in one place at one time. So you're not stagnant thinking about the fights and start getting your adrenaline and everything else going. Want to be relaxed and be around good people like that contribute, you know.
Well, it's good to be around great energy too, because that's a big factor.
Sure.
You know, and how do you deal with that? You know, there's obviously so many negative factors that, you know, can come into just in life in general, but as a fighter, time with family, friends, or doing the things, you know, how do you deal with balancing all of that and sometimes often negative things that come your way?
Right. To be honest, it's been difficult at times. I would say that's probably the biggest struggle yet as being an athlete, trying to balance my time with family and friends and even just past relationships. It's hard.
Yeah.
It's really hard. You have to sacrifice a lot.
Yeah.
To, you know, for a greater purpose and a greater goal that you're trying to reach.
Well, you have to believe.
In what you believe in,
yeah.
And luckily I do have a huge support system with my family and my Fight Club family.
Yes.
That helps me to get through this day to day.
Correct. And I sensed that, you know, when I was at the last fight, I sensed very much a close-knit group, you know, camaraderie that you guys have, the support that you give one another.
And it's literally families there.
Yes.
I mean, it's not just a bunch of dudes that think she's good-looking and they want to support her. It's a bunch of families and kids, parents, and people that they have a lot of respect and they appreciate her, so they will support, man. And they go home and they're texting their kids at night, like, hey, how did she do? they're like these 7-8 year old kids in our class, and yes, they want to know. But she's got a really good fan base, and there's just more of a family network and people that care.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? That's what we try to develop as a team. We want people, we want you fighting more for just the win, like I said, like Lauren said earlier. It's like, hey, there's a whole thing we're trying to accomplish here.
Yeah.
And how do people perceive us, man?
Yes.
You know, I mean, it's not what you're going to do. It's like, how are you going to do this? Yeah, as well as winning, which is important.
Well, before we close out, any shout-outs, Lauren or Charlie, that y'all want to give out to the club, to the family, to the friends, to the crew, whatever?
Yeah, you know, through this this fight journey that I'm on and this whole process, I have crossed paths with, you know, some people that have really just made a huge impact in my life. Some people that I just feel deserve a thank you from me to hear that. First being my family. I want to thank, you know, my mom and my dad for their love and support, standing yes, beside me and just really supporting my dream.
Yes.
And going for this career path and having nothing but kind words for me. My Aunt Lori plays a huge factor in my life. She's battling MS, so she's fighting for her life day to day. And growing up seeing that, she has taught me, you know, what it takes really to be a fighter within yourself. So she's shown me a lot, so I want to thank her for, you know, the fight that she continues to do every day.
That's awesome.
I also want to thank a friend, Tyler Sayal, who came into the gym when I first started out
mm-hmm.
in MMA, and I didn't know what MMA was about or what it took to be a pro athlete. And he showed me a lot. He pushed me every day with training and guided me in that way, and just sacrificing his time, so I want to thank him for that.
Right.
I want to thank my coaches. I truly believe I have the best. Charlie Kohler, for all of his dedication and sacrifices he's made to train me. Dave and Bernard.
Right.
You know, I feel the best of the best.
Well, that's amazing.
You know, that comes from friends to family to my fight team. So I just want to thank everybody.
Well, I want to thank you guys for coming in today, Charlie
thank
and Lauren.
You,
shout out to the Fight Club. If you guys want to learn how to fight with the best and train with the best, go over to Fight Club and visit Charlie. He'll take care of you, make sure you get guided in the right direction. Before I close out, I want to make an announcement. We have the Relish 10-year anniversary skate demo that's coming up August 28th from 4 to 6 p.m. at National City Kimball Park. It's going to be inspiring kids and families through skateboarding. There are going to be prizes, giveaways, live music, and also, obviously, skateboarding. So you can obviously direct message me on Facebook or on Instagram for more information, or contact me directly at 619-512-9120. Thank you guys for coming in again. This has been an amazing experience.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you, Rob.
I look forward to following your journey. I know we're going to see you in the UFC soon. You're going to be knocking some girl to hell out.
Heck
so
yeah.
I wish you the best. All
right,
that's
right
it, guys. Until right, next time, have a great weekend and be safe. Bye.
Alliance Escrow, the most reliable and hardworking.
I love you, Lauren.
Diego. Buying, selling, or refinancing a home can be a stressful.